Hello everyone! The topic of today's video is the use of quercetin in patients with COVID-19. Currently, there are COVID-19 management protocols and doctor's recommendations to add quercetin to the treatment regimen. Quercetin is a polyphenolic flavonoid found in abundance in many fruits and herbs. Extracts of quercetin have been used to treat or prevent diverse conditions, including cardiovascular disease, hypercholesterolemia, rheumatic diseases, infections and cancer, but have not been shown to be effective in clinical trials for any medical condition. What was the design and type of those studies? What methods did the authors use? How did they process the information? What was the aim of those studies? All these points affect the result of the study. On the contrary, several studies have shown that quercetin may have health benefits by improving metabolic functions, modulating inflammation, and lowering serum cholesterol levels. Let's dive deeper. As I said before, quercetin is a flavonoid. Flavonoids have antioxidant effects that can protect against cell damage. In vitro antioxidants such as quercetin have been shown to reduce the oxidation of cholesterol esters, which may play a role in the pathogenesis of atherosclerosis. Quercetin also has anti-inflammatory activity, suppressing the production of various components of allergic reactions. In cell cultures and animal models, quercetin appears to have anti-cancerogenic effects. Finally, quercetin has been formulated to improve athletic performance and reduce post-workout inflammation and oxidative stress. What effects can quercetin have on coronavirus infection? Firstly, there is some recent evidence of the anti-coronavirus activities of quercetin, including against SARS-CoV main proteases and S protein. Its assumed ability to inhibit coronavirus and its well-described anti-inflammatory role make quercetin a possible new candidate for outpatient treatment of COVID-19. Quercetin has anti-inflammatory properties that include inhibition of various pro-inflammatory cytokines. This effect of quercetin may be especially important in the pulmonary phase of COVID-19, cytokine storm. The anti-inflammatory effect of quercetin has been proven by metagenomic analysis. Analysis showed that the addition of quercetin significantly reduces CRP levels. CRP, or C-reactive protein, is an inflammatory biomarker reflecting levels of pro-inflammatory cytokines. CRP is one of the most important predictive markers in COVID-19 patients, and quercetin significantly reduces CRP levels. Second point, as we age and the degree of inflammation increases, the level of cholesterol in the blood rises. Cholesterol increases the number of points of entry of coronavirus into the cell, thus enhances the penetration of SARS-CoV-2 into the cell. Another entry point for SARS-CoV-2 into the cell is angiotensin-converting enzyme 2, ACE2 receptors. Quercetin inhibits the expression of ACE2 and lowers blood cholesterol levels, thereby blocking the penetration of coronavirus into the cell. Thus, quercetin might provide double protection against SARS-CoV-2. Thirdly, quercetin has important immunomodulatory properties that may be important for patients with SARS-CoV-2 infection. Quercetin affects the activity of neutrophils, enhances the proliferation of lymphocytes, and stimulates T helpers to produce interferons. These are special proteins secreted by the cells of the body in response to the invasion of viruses, bacteria, and some toxins. This could be critical for patients with COVID-19 infection. Finally, although the exact antiviral mechanisms of quercetin are not yet fully understood, there is a significant body of evidence supporting the broad antiviral properties of quercetin, demonstrating inhibition of the replication of several respiratory viruses, including influenza virus, parainfluenza virus, respiratory syncytial virus, adenovirus, and rhinovirus. The addition of quercetin to the diet of influenza-infected mice significantly reduces levels of both superoxide radicals and lipid peroxidation products. So, quercetin may be useful as an antiviral therapy. I found an interesting 2-week still ongoing prospective randomized controlled and open-label study. In this study, the authors enrolled 42 outpatients with COVID-19 symptoms. Preliminary study results showed that use of quercetin as adjuvant supplementation of a daily dose of 1500 mg per day first week and of 1000 mg per day second week significantly improves some of clinical outcomes considered: virus clearance, symptoms frequency, lactate dehydrogenase LDH, ferritin at the same time being very well tolerated by users. Quercetin is found in many foods and herbs and is a regular component of a normal diet. It is found in dill, capers, buckwheat, onions, especially red, in large quantities in the outer shells, garlic, broccoli, cauliflower, cabbage and lovage. An important note, lovage is contraindicated in pregnancy as it promotes blood flow to the pelvic organs. Also, quercetin is found in red grapes, citrus fruits, various berries, in drinks such as tea and red wine, in olive oil, nuts, and also in tomatoes. One study found that organically grown tomatoes had 79% more quercetin than non-organically grown fruit. Quercetin is present in various kinds of honey from different plant sources, for example, eucalyptus honey and tea tree honey. There have been no published reports of clinically apparent liver damage associated with quercetin. Indeed, many in vitro and in vivo studies have shown that quercetin protects against liver damage caused by drugs and toxins, including paracetamol and cancer chemotherapeutic agents. Studies in which quercetin was taken at the dosage of 1000 mg per day for up to 2 months found no side effects or safety concerns. FDA considers up to 500 mg per serving quercetin to be generally recognized as safe. Quercetin is usually prescribed at the dosage of 250 to 500 and even 1000 mg per day. In particular, in critical care COVID-19 management protocol of Eastern Virginia Medical School, quercetin is recommended for prophylaxis at the dosage 250 mg daily. For mildly symptomatic patients, quercetin can be taken at the dosage 250 and 500 mg twice a day. The use of quercetin together with vitamin C and zinc enhances its beneficial effects and increases its bioavailability. Moreover, quercetin acts as zinc ionophore, and it has been demonstrated that exogenous zinc inhibits RNA-dependent RNA polymerase activity of SARS-CoV in dose-dependent manner. Due to the beneficial properties of quercetin, it is included in a large number of multivitamin supplements. Quercetin as a phytosomal complex is easily absorbed by the intestines. There is quercetin lipomycel on the market, which is absorbed 10 times better than ordinary quercetin. Quercetin is possibly safe when given in appropriate amounts. Side effects may include flushing, sweating, nausea, vomiting, difficulty breathing, but large doses are possibly unsafe. There have been reports of kidney damage at high doses. Consult your doctor if you have kidney problems and want to take quercetin. Quercetin might interact with lots of medicines. Quercetin might decrease the effectiveness of some antibiotics. Taking quercetin with cyclosporine, diclofenac, losartan, pravastatin, warfarin, etc. might increase the effects and also side effects of these drugs. Quercetin might lower blood sugar in people with diabetes. Taking quercetin along with diabetes medications might cause blood sugar to go too low. You need to monitor your blood sugar closely and possibly adjust your diabetes medication dosage. Quercetin seems to decrease blood pressure. Be careful when taking antihypertensive medications and quercetin at the same time. Taking quercetin along with some medications that are broken down by the liver can increase the effects and side effects of these medications. Generally, before taking quercetin, talk to a healthcare provider. Given its wide range of health benefits, quercetin offers hope for successful use in COVID-19 patients. However, we need more honest research and monitoring of coronavirus patients. If this video was useful for you, put your thumbs up, write your comments, questions, wishes, and be sure to subscribe to my channel so as not to miss the next videos. I am going to talk about cool energy boosting medications. And of course, take care of your body and mind. See you! Thank you.